My name is Patty Weaver. I was born in Mexico, and I was raised in Pacific Beach, California. I attended a Catholic school, church, I'm sorry, but stopped going there when I was very young. After that, I felt really lost, and I felt like there was something missing in my life. So for many years, I didn't attend any churches until one day, a friend of mine, very good friend of mine, Lori Sutherland, invited me to come to Sailorville Church. I came and I was really pleased. Everyone here was so friendly and warm and kind that I decided right then that this was the church for me. After that, Chuck the Clean called me and asked me if I'd like to take some Bible classes, and I agreed that I would. And that's when I started to realize what it meant to be a Christian, that all you have to do is put your complete trust in our Lord Jesus Christ and know that he died on the cross for my sins. And then I received Jesus into my life last November of last year, and I can honestly say that since that day, I've felt this joy in my heart, overwhelming joy that I have never felt before.
Way to go, Patty.
Thank you.
She was really nervous to pull this thing off. Who are some of the people besides Chuck that have been working in your life, you and Delvin's life?
Larry and Dorothy Woodcraft, mm-hmm. and Dick. And, well, we've got a whole
bunch
sailor,
of people.
We have a Bible group, yeah. And we love those people. They've been so supportive and wonderful to us. We feel like we have a new family. We love them, and they've helped us. And I'm really proud to be a Christian, call myself a Christian, and I will always keep praying and have faith and learn for the rest of my life.
Amen, girl. Amen. Let's hear from your husband. How's that?
Thank you.
Delvin, step up to the plate here.
Hi, my name's Delvin. I grew up on stock and dairy farms in southwest Iowa, one of five boys. I attended the Methodist Church till I was a teenager, and at that time my mom and dad let me make my own decision whether I wanted to go to church or not. Of course, I made the wrong decision. While I had a general understanding of religion, I made a lot of bad decisions in life, especially in my younger years. One with great regret and shame, not exposing my children to the Christian way of life. When my mother passed away last year, last spring, I started to think about heaven and what that meant, and I knew that my mom and dad had been accepted Christ into their lives, but I didn't really know what that meant. So, you know, I just kind of went along there like that. Then Patty's friend, Lori Sutherland, invited her to church, and she was attending church, and they were doing the Bible study. And one night they came to our house, and I kind of got roped into participating. I was trying to hide out at my father-in-law's house, and she called and said, "Come home." So I soon learned what it meant to, or what had been missing in my life, why things hadn't always been quite right. And Chuck, he worked with me for a while, and then he handed me off to Dick and Tom. I don't know, too much for him, I guess. Anyway, through them, I began to understand what it meant to believe in Christ and what it meant to be saved and to uh, believe in Jesus Christ. Amen. And so with help from them, I've come a long ways.
Yeah. You placed your faith in Christ, didn't you? With
that? Yes, I did.
Yeah.
Thanks to Dick and Larry and Dorothy Wheatcraft and the rest of our cell group, I've gained a much better life. Mm. I now have a feeling what is right. Mm. And I accepted Christ into my life in February. Amen. And amen.
Amen. Amen.
You know, before that, I picked up a Bible probably a few dozen times in my life and was never able to even finish one page. Mm. And working with them, now I enjoy reading the Bible, and I have a pretty good understanding what I'm reading. And if I don't, I know where I can go. I can go to my cell group and these people that have really befriended us. Hmm. And I think we'll have a real good life.
And you already do. You have eternal life, don't you?
Yes. Yep.
And we praise the Lord for your testimonies, Delvin, Patty, and we really, you know, I was thinking when you talk about, you're thinking about heaven, I was thinking about in one of the last chapters of the Bible, in the vision that John has, he says, God says, behold, I make all things new. And that's what he's done in your lives.
Yes.
He's going to make things, all things literally new someday, but he made them virtually new in your lives when you trusted Jesus as your Savior.
Absolutely.
And so we rejoice. Let's rejoice with Delvin and Patty and pray for them before we baptize them. How's that? Come over here. Let's pray together. Lord, thanks so much for the Weavers. Thank you for Delvin, thank you for Patty, thank you for their testimonies, thank you for the people you brought into their lives, from Chuck to Dick Ober, Tom Kimberly, Lord, and then the cell group, the Wheatcrafts, and all these who are becoming so very precious and so very special to their lives and building into their lives. Lord, it gives us great joy. We baptized somebody just a few moments ago that was young, and now we're baptizing somebody who's a little bit more long in their years, and yet you save people at all ages. And we're grateful for that. There are people here, Lord, that need to be saved. And I pray that they will have heard these testimonies from these two and indeed bow the knee to Jesus like they did. Now, bless them as they go from here. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Delvin, we'll do you first.
You step over here, man.
Okay.
And we'll turn you around this way. And upon your profession of faith, Delvin, and in obedience to God's word, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Patty, praise the Lord for your story as well. And upon your profession of faith, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.